Hello, my name is Damien Jeeves and welcome to my talk on IVES, a modular toolkit for 3D audiovisual composition in Max. With the emergence of immersive technologies, there has been a steady growth in the interest in 3D audiovisual works among composers and media artists. This could be observed for a long time in the field of spatial composition, but also in the visual field of 3D worlds, and recently, especially in the area of virtual and augmented reality. For this purpose, a lot of tools and software for creating 3D audiovisual environments were created. For spatial music composition, dedicated software as well as specialized libraries for music and audio programming languages such as Max, Pure Data, SuperCollider, etc. were created. In the field of 3D world making, it is especially tools like 3D engines for games, but also programming languages for visual composition such as Touch Designer or VVVV. While the visual composition tools like 3D engines are very powerful in the visual domain, the possibilities on the audio side might be too limited for many composition requirements. Things like real-time multi-channel input and output, sound synthesis, generative composition, deeper control of the signal processing, and sound spatialization might be missing to an extent in these tools. Music and audio programming languages, on the other hand, often have limitations in creating visual 3D environments and using VR and AR systems. And when possible, the implementation of audiovisual 3D environments requires additional effort and special knowledge on these topics. As a result, there are various efforts to extend the functionality of these tools and programming languages with the help of add-ons, plugins, libraries, and frameworks to facilitate the creation of audiovisual 3D environments. Another approach is to connect music and audio programming languages with tools like 3D engines in order to combine the best of these two worlds. Although all these approaches are quite promising, there are a number of good reasons that speak for developing audiovisual 3D environments in a programming language like Max. Max is a graphical programming language widely known and used among composers and media artists. With the inclusion of appropriate programming libraries, the requirements are met to create and render audiovisual 3D environments in Max. There are various sophisticated libraries for spatial audio rendering, like SPAD or the ICST Ambisonic tools. The in Max integrated library Jitter has an implementation of the OpenGL API, allowing to create and render 3D objects and worlds. The VR package allows to use PC VR systems, including head-mounted displays and tracking devices inside the Max programming environment. But even if these libraries simplify a lot, and advanced programmers might be able to create their own rendering systems and virtual environments with them, it still requires additional work and special knowledge to program them. All rendering pipelines must be programmed and correctly parameterized. Data exchanged between these libraries must be converted, for example, because of different coordinate systems and conventions, and much more. To overcome these obstacles and simplify the creation of 3D audiovisual environments in Max, we developed IVES, a modular toolkit for 3D audiovisual composition in Max. It provides higher-level building block modules with graphical user interfaces for spatial audiovisual rendering and composition. It automates processes such as the conversion of data and control messages, as well as parameterization between the libraries used. IVES uses the already mentioned library SPAD5 for spatial audio rendering and composition, Jitter with OpenGL for 3D world making and rendering, and the VR package for interfacing with PC VR systems, including head-mounted displays and tracking systems. As a result, the toolkit offers a number of modules for different purposes. Spatial audio modules for creating and processing a spatial sound field, modules for building and rendering virtual worlds and 3D objects, and modules for controlling and interacting with object positions, trajectories, grids, and patterns. To give you a better understanding of the system, here is a short demonstration that explains the concept of using the IVES toolkit with a simple example. It's recommended to wear headphones for binaural listening. Once you install the package, you can access the IVES modules from the context menu in the Max programming environment. Let's start with the sound field module. It's a core module to handle information about objects and positions in our virtual environment. To overlay the sound field, we need the encoder module to encode as well as the decoder module to decode the sound field to the desired reproduction system. The OSC as well as the signal in and outlets needs to be connected in the order of the rendering pipeline. Parameters are automatically transferred to the following modules to ensure consistency throughout the rendering pipelines. For decoding, we choose the binaural decoder for headphone-based reproduction. Let's bring in the visual 3D world making. You can choose between the environment module for screen-based reproduction or the VR environment for using PC VR systems. Again, we connect the OSC in and outlets. And once we refresh the sound feed module, our virtual sound source also appears visually in our 3D world. To add other objects, we can use the eye shape module. We connect it to the sound field. And now we can link its position to our virtual sound source. We can change the geometric type and do other transformations. When we now move our sound source, we can see it's moving our added object. And now let's add sound. We can add the sound source module to generate a test noise for our virtual sound source. When we now move it around, we will hear and see it's moving in our audiovisual 3D environment. With the Ives toolkit, we wanted to create a system for composers and media artists with a focus on music and audio, which allows them to easily create audiovisual 3D works in MAX. At this stage, we have managed to provide the necessary functions to render and create basic audiovisual 3D worlds. The audio reproduction can be done on loudspeaker or headphone-based systems, video reproduction on screen or VR-based systems. Currently, the toolkit still has limitations in the area of visual world design, especially in comparison with tools like game engines. In the long run, our goal is not to replace these tools, especially from a technical point of view, but rather to provide an alternative with a focus on music and audio and the possibility for new creative and artistic forms to emerge. Nevertheless, in the near future, we want to improve and extend the capabilities of the toolkit in the area of visual 3D world generation. It is also planned to create additional interfaces for further controllers, tracking devices, and software from the field of spatial composition. Another special focus will be on the modules for composing with the sound field in the spatial domain, also known as the spherical harmonics domain. Thank you for your interest in the Ives toolkit. Further information can be found in the related paper. The toolkit itself can be found on our GitHub repository under the link as provided.